In just a few simple steps, I can demonstrate the easiest way to create this digital art. Moreover, given the community vote and most people have rather weak computers for work, so this way will be very useful and get an answer to the question of how to create digital art within a simple way, even for beginners and experienced artists. Welcome to another episode on my channel. My name is Slavo, I am a digital artist. If you're the first time here, don't forget to subscribe, smash the like button, and let's dive into creativity. This pretty simple art that I created approximately in an hour, and I need only a few 3D models and something special, I will tell you, just watch this video till the end. I have these 3D models, a ship, a few stones, a few models for details, and that's everything, just what you need to create a stunning art. All these models are free models available to everyone. This ship, barrel and broken parts I took from Polyhaven, which also has a lot of 3D models, textures and HDRIs. These rocks are simple mega scans, also available for free. So let's open the blender and I'll show you a couple of features of how you can create art in an hour with only a couple of free 3D models. I immediately add empty, plain axis. I select all the parts of the ship and the new empty object and press Ctrl+P to choose set parent to object with hip transform without inverse. This allows me to move the ship without selecting all parts every time when I wanna move it. Just select the empty object and move. So I move the ship to the same position as on my art and rotate it as it was in a shipwreck and the ship got stuck in the reefs. Some kind of like this. When I make the ocean, I can adjust the rotation of the ship, but for now that's enough. Next, I add a simple plane and open modifiers. In the physics, find ocean. I copy all my settings from my base scene. If you need the same, here you can see my settings for the ocean modifier, as you saw on my digital art. For more information on how to make an ocean in Blender, you can find a bunch of videos on YouTube, but in this video I would like to notice some important part of them. Resolution impact on how many details will be on your ocean surface. Obviously, viewport works only for viewports and render for render. That means you may use a higher value for the final render and smaller one for working in the viewport. The time parameter allows you to animate the ocean, but if you create a static image, it also works as well. Just choose the interesting position of waves. Also, in the waves, scale allows you to make waves higher or lower. If you need some form, turn on form and type the name of the data layer. This parameter needs for shading to add the form from waves using the attribute node. The full shader on my ocean you may see on the screen. As I said, on YouTube you may find a lot of videos about the setting of the ocean in a Blender, so I keep going to talk about my art. Next, I will add these rocks here as a reef near the ship, so this ship crashed and got stuck as happens in the storm. And I will use these rocks here as more massive rocks for the second plan. Since this is not the foreground, you can use less detailed scanned models. Then I will show you why. As you see, there are only three main objects in my scene, and this is all that can be seen in this art. Everything is very simple. Next, turn on viewport shading and let's make an atmospheric light. Of course, we can find the necessary HDRI on Polyhaven, but I would like to make it another way. I have this image sky with atmospheric clouds, and this is a good fit for my art. So I add a new plane and new shader. Drag and drop my sky image to the blender and connect it with the base color and emission. I need just edit emission strings to get the sky more bright. For ambient light, I leave the base render light and just change the color to something like this. Now I don't like how it looks like these holes in the horizon. I would like to make this horizon line more attractive, so let's add some mountains on the horizon to get varied shape of the horizon line. Definitely we can use 3D models for this, but this is an extra load on computer and in general unnecessary. So let me show you a simple way. I have this image of mountains which we can use as background as we made for the sky. We just need to make an alpha channel to use this in a blender. For this, open Photoshop and through this image. Using the object selection tool, I can easily select the mountain and add a mask layer. If it's necessary, adjust the mask to get the nice selection. Next, I fill the background with black and save this image's base. Use the mask and fill it with white on new layer. This will be my alpha. In the blender, everything is the same as we did for the sky. Blend the new shader and connect my main image to the base color and alpha to the alpha. As we see, we got realistic mountains that we can place further away on the horizon, somewhere here, and duplicate to the opposite side of the art here. In this way, you can do some kind of 3D mod painting and do not need a powerful PC for this because it's an image and on the render it doesn't not require a lot of RAM to make a final render easily. As you see, creating realistic digital art it's not so hard and possible even using 3D models and images instead of them, and even if you do not have a powerful PC it works as well. This method is especially good for background. For the foreground, I still use 3D models for more realistic result. This is such result for now, and you can probably say that why an image should blend at all when you can do in a Photoshop. Of course, you can leave this render in a blender, make a final render and go to Photoshop to paint over the render as I show you in my previous video. Between us, you can do this also using compositing in a blender. But we'll stay in a blender and I'll show you why. First, it will be organically integrated into the environment. For instance, using this way, you will get a reflection from the sky and the object which you added. Secondly, I add a simple cube, make it larger and add a new shader with volume scatter material instead of principal BSDF with small density and see what happened now on my render. Volume fog in this case works as a combined layer and everything becomes like a natural picture. Also we see the depth appear in my render. Due to the fog the background looks like quite picturesque. We can change the color and density to get different result and it already looks like finished art without Photoshop. So I added the sky and background mountains in a blender instead of Photoshop to get this picturesque effect, but in most cases I work by combining Blender and Photoshop. I will open Photoshop again to draw a little detail on my render and make a final post-production. I wanna draw how water flows down the ship because we have a storm and we need to add a little bit of details like splashes, torn ropes and a little bit of waves near the storm. So let's start with the ship and draw the water. I use several layers to draw water on one of them and splashes on the other because in this case the water cannot be uniform and it is also necessary to show on the art. I paint with simple brush and erase tool with pressure and rather weak opacity value. This allows me to make the water transparent and not uniform. I just paint the water and here erase the not necessary part, step by step achieving nice looking water. So using the same way I am going to draw waves, also two layers, one of them for splashes and the second is just a fill layer. Using the paint tool I am drawing ropes and slightly remove them with the erase tool in some part so that they have more variety in thickness. I'll add some birds and again remove some of them for a more natural image. The last stage is post-production. I combine all layers into one, convert this layer into the smart object and press Ctrl-Shift-A to open a camera roll. lightly raise the contrast and shadows. In the same turn, I decrease blacks for more dramatic effect. Next, add a mask to make the foreground more darker. This helps me to add more depth and make this spotlight here to emphasize the main part of the art. So here is my render, which I made at the previous stage of work using a blender. We add some water on the ship, added waves and splashes for a more detailed picture. Made details on the ship so that it looked like it got shipwrecked. Of course, birds and post-production in camera roll. I hope this video demonstrates that it takes not much to create digital art. More important, how do you have limited resources to use it all? Of course, for some tasks you will need a powerful PC if you want to do simulation, animation, or just work with the large scene. But as you can see, it's possible to make your creative art for a portfolio or other purpose, even having a laptop. Subscribe to my channel to see more videos about Blender, Photoshop and digital art. Hit the like button and see you in the next one.